Hi and welcome to another card making video. Today I'm going to play with a February kit of foiling by Spellbinders, and I'm also going to play with a new color, Kitsch Flamingo by Tim Holtz. I'm starting by combining Kitsch Flamingo with Spiced Marmalade, which is a combination which is absolutely stunning. I inked up both ends of this paper all the way to the middle. I made sure that both ends are nicely saturated with color, which is something very easy to do with the oxides. The ink kind of stays at the top. And then I'm going to blend those two colors together, making sure that I don't have a harsh line. As you can see, I go over that line again and again, very lightly, and it works just like magic. It is a really stunning background and I absolutely love this color combo. If you like it as it is, you can use it and just stick your focal point on top and your sentiment. I decided to go with some water splashes. I leave them for a few seconds to react with the ink and then I'm going to use a paper towel. And this is going to lift some of the color for a very interesting background. I'm going to bring in the Spellbinders Foiling Kit of the Month, and this time it comes with those essential plates. These are going to give you a really beautiful design all around, and you can use them as a frame or even to frame a little sentiment. There are also three sentiments included. One is for birthdays, the other one is a thank you, and there is also the word hello. I'm going to use the biggest of those plates and align it on top of my background, and I'm also going to combine one of the sentiments. I usually send a lot of thank you cards, so I'm going to use the thank you sentiment here. For my foil, I decided to go with gold, and you will see that that gold on top of Kitsch Flamingo is absolutely stunning. I'm using my little trimmer by Spellbinders, which is very handy when it comes to foiling. And this way I can easily measure and not waste any foil at all. And since I want to do both the frame as well as the sentiment in one passing, I'm going to create a hinge, then place the foil underneath. And I'm going to also secure the sentiment on top, making sure that it is as straight as possible. I'm just going to eyeball that and then secure everything down with some washi tape. I have my machine warming up. I'm going to place that on top of the platform. I press the button and waiting for that green light to stop blinking as I am preparing the sandwich, and then I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. I always run it a couple of times. This will ensure that you have a good contact of the foil and the warm plate, and you will have a good impression every time. Now I'm going to very carefully remove the plates without burning my fingers. And you can see the wonderful result. This frame is absolutely stunning and is going straight into my essentials because it makes a card look finished and it adds that extra something on the frame. Also, the three sentiments that are included with all those nested frames are essential as well, and in between thank you, happy birthday and hello, you can create a huge variety of cards. Now, if you are frugal like me with your supplies, don't throw away this foil. There is plenty of foil in the middle that I haven't used and I can use it on another project. Now, if you notice at the top corner, I do have some overfoiling. I can easily remove that with a sand eraser, very lightly, making sure that I don't remove any of that inking from the background. I don't press my sand eraser, I'm just gliding it over the foil. And you can see that I can remove that with no issues at all, and without removing any inking from the background. Now, at this stage, you have a beautiful background with a sentiment, and all you have to do is to just stick a focal point on top. I decided to go with a flower that I had in my stash, and I die cut it. You can go with any flower, stamp, or die that you have at your stash. It would look just beautiful. Just because I have the pink and orange at the background, I decided to go with a daisy, and mainly staying with white. The white flower on top of that background is going to look really stunning and vibrant. It's going to have a good contrast, and this is something that I always go with when I am deciding my color combinations. On all my die cuts, I do add a little bit of movement by using those sculpting tools. You can do that with your fingers if you don't have something similar. And I'm going to assemble my die-cut flower. By the way, this daisy is by Altenew, and just like always, you will find everything I use down below in the description area, linked to multiple shops. I did stick the center of the flower with foam tape at the back since I have enough dimension, and also I have foam tape at the back of my flower. I like to have some dimension on my cards and I cannot stay away from that. Now I'm going to stick the leaves, just tuck them underneath the flower, and all I have to do then is to stick this panel on top of a pre-folded card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And that was the project for today, a card that smells like spring, although we are expecting loads of snow on Saturday. And as a thank you, I'm going to send this card to one of you. All you have to do is to just like the video, leave me a comment, and I will pick a random winner and get in touch with you. Along with this card, you will also get some goodies. So I hope that you had fun today and that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I hope you will all have a lovely weekend.